Hey skaters, today I come to introduce you the Maxfine FF, one of the weirdest boards you will find in the market. Let's go in.
As you can see, this board has some stuff that we can recognize. For example, you can see the ESC and the battery are separated by a distance, like the boosted board. Everything else is super different and has some crazy stuff that I never seen before, and you will find it in this review. So let's start with the deck. You might think that it's carbon fiber, but it's not. It's super flex propylene sulfide plus glass fiber. This means that the deck is super flexy, even too much for my personal taste, but it will make more comfortable the hub configuration, and it looks really great. One of the things I like more of this board is the handle in the front side that makes it really convenient and makes carry the board really easy and comfortable, and I think this is one of the great assets of this board. The deck is not symmetrical, as you can see, it's more wide in the front foot side. The tracks are double kimping, which is strange to find a double kimping tracks in a hub motor version, which I think it's really interesting. They are 11.4 inch wide, which is great for carving. I find the bushings are really too soft, but I'm 92 kilos, so it's pretty normal that I find too soft this kind of bushings. But if you tight it enough, it's really comfortable and predictable turning, so it's great. You cannot go full speed because it's easy to get some wobbles. The wobbles are the vibrations you get when you are not in a correct body position on the skateboard and you are going fast. In this case, looks that Maxfine decided to make his own tracks, which is interesting because it's a design that I never seen before. The wheels are 96 millimeters, 3.8 inch and 78A endurance. I really found in these wheels a really comfortable ride because they are good quality. You know, usually when you bought some boards, they came with really bad wheels. One of the interesting things of these sleeves is that you can use the cloud wheel donuts, the 105 and the 120 millimeters ones, and they will fit perfectly and they will make the ride even more comfortable. Because even the board is hub motors, with the flexibility of the deck and the cloud wheels, you can make it super super extra comfortable, but you will get less range, which is something you have to take in account with this setting change. And since we are talking about wheels, you have to know that Maxfine offers another version of this skate that it's called FF Plus. The difference between these boards is that the FF Plus have 165 millimeter wheels. This board has two hub motors, 750 watts each, and they get a top speed of 25 miles per hour, 40 kilometers per hour. I got 37 kilometers per hour, which is great, I think. The ESC is a Hobbywing 9005, and it's not the version you can turn on the board through the remote, so you will have to use always the button under the deck where you can find the charging port. And one of the things I don't like of this board is the ESC configuration, because the acceleration is good, the top speed is nice, but the brake is pretty soft. This makes me think this board is more for a novice rider. But now Maxfine released a new board with belt drive, which will be for sure more aggressive in acceleration and braking, so maybe if you are experienced rider, you prefer to go that way, since it's almost the same board but with belts and with a little more battery. Since we are talking about the battery, Maxfine FF comes with 6.4 amps 230 watts hour, but still in 36 volts, which I think it could be great if they upgrade to the new 55 volts batteries and motors, which makes the board more efficient. And for those who are more interested in DIY, this board comes with an LG 10S 2P. this will make the board a little saggy, but one of the main assets of this board is that the battery is swappable, so you can get all the range you want just by adding another battery. This is a really fast swap battery design, pretty similar to the Backfire Mini. It's not perfect, but I think it's a great option, and it will make this board really light, since it's only 9.1 kilos, which is a good weight. And if you are only commuting, it will be great because it will be not super heavy. But if you want to make a long ride with your friends, you can add another battery. One of the good things of this system is that you can use your old batteries of your old skateboards with this board if it fits in the compartment, so maybe you can get them a second life. So this is one of the main features of this board. What I found is that the FlexiDead don't affect the integrity of the battery pack, but this is a thing that has to be proven with a more long testing.
The MaxFine FF Street has an autonomy of 21 miles, 35 kilometers, according to MaxFine. I got 25 kilometers using the board in the max setting and riding really aggressively.
The grip tape, it's not a grip tape as usual. It's a frosting material. It's some kind of texturized plastic. It's great if you are riding in dry environments, but if the deck gets wet, I think it will be a little slippery or not as grippy as we want. And since we are talking about water, the waterproof rating of this board, it's IP65, which is really good, and I don't want to try it because I don't really like to ride with street wheels on water or under rain on wet environments. But remember that, as I always say,
any brand will not guarantee
anything about water. So this IP65 rating, it's only if you find in a position that you can avoid water, but it's better if you never ride under wet conditions. MaxFine was known because of his affordable e-skateboards. I like that they are trying to make new stuff in the market, like these boards with everything integrated in the deck and with good quality components. And with these boards, you are paying a lot of this design and development expenses. The MaxFine FF Street price, it's $799. 709 euros. In my modest opinion, it's a little bit expensive, but if you like the design, it's one of the caveats you will have to accept. One of the few things I don't like it, it's the ESC configuration. As I said, the braking, it's too soft. That the deck, it's not symmetrical, it's really bothering me visually, aesthetically. It's strange, this design. I think it would be great if the wideness of the front foot were in the back foot too. And it's strange too that the deck is not carbon fiber, but I understand. A lot of brands are releasing boards of carbon fiber, but if you really like the aesthetics but you want a flexi deck and not pay the overprice of a carbon fiber deck, this is a great solution, which in my case, it's not a big deal, and make the board looks really great. So here is my review of the MaxFine FF Street version. If you like the content, please like, subscribe, and if you have any questions, you can make it in the comment box, and see you in the next review.
Hey skaters, today I will show you how to change the battery pack of your MaxFine FF. Now you have 24 more kilometers to go. Enjoy your ride.